This episode from 1974 features ultra-cool DJ Mel Mounds, the Short Circus, doing the stop song, and the adventures of Letterman, and lots of Easy Reader.
Today on The Electric Company, you'll see Sally read the simple word.
Now you sing along with us. You know what I mean?
Down.
got to read that message. It's very important.
Do not bother this giant person. Do not bother this giant person. Oh, excuse me, sir. I seem to be having trouble reading this.
What? Do not bother this giant person. That's me.
Do not bother this giant person.
Once there was a lady who lived in a very simple house. She wore very simple clothes. She ate very simple things. Drank very simple things. She even read very simple things.
See Dick. See Jane. See Spot. The end. Now that's what I like. A nice simple book with nice simple words. Nothing fancy.
Then came a knock at her simple door. The lady got up from her simple chair to see who it was.
You are Sally Simple?
Yes, I am.
Sally Simple. Yes. I got a message for you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, dear, I am exhausted from reading that book, and now I have to read this message. Oh, well.
Sally Simple took one look at the message and said,
Are you kidding? I'm supposed to read this? Look at the size of this word. And this word. And this word.
And so Sally Simple read only the simple words of the message.
You will meet. Forget the rest.
Then Sally Simple took down the message, tore it up, and threw it away. But suddenly, a piece of note she had thrown in the basket caught her eye.
Wait a minute. I know this word. This word is some. Oh, my. And I know this word. This word is day. You will. Someday you will meet. Someday you will meet. One. Let's see. Oh. Someday you will meet one. Here's the word some again. Let's see. Oh. Someone. Someday you will meet someone. I know this word. Hand. Someday you will meet someone. Hand. I bet I know what this word is. Some. Handsome. Someday you will meet someone handsome.
And so Sally Semple learned that sometimes long, fancy-looking words can be two simple words just stuck together.
Imagine, sometimes long, fancy-looking words can just be two simple words stuck together. Someday, someone, handsome.
Suddenly there was another knock at Sally Simple's door.
Hey, Simple, I forgot to have you sign for the message.
Would you take off your glasses? And would you please take off your hair? Oh, you are handsome. In a simple sort of way.
Thank you. Listen, would you like to go for a ride on my motorbike? It's right out there.
I'd love to. I'll be with you in a jiffy.
Okay.
And so, Sally Simple and her handsome someone lived happily ever after.
First, I'd like to go have a steak, and then for dessert, we could have a banana split, you know, the kind with three ice creams and any kind of...
Some. Some. Someone. Someone. Handsome. Handsome. Someone. Handsome. Oh, I bet you mean me.
Let's see now. Dear Miss... No. Why, hello there, Miss Jones. No, it's no use. I can't think of anything.
What's wrong?
Well, I want to call my teacher. It's her birthday. I want to tell her something nice.
Well, how about... Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
No, everybody sings that. I want to sing, something different.
Well, how about roses are red, violets are blue.
Oh, forget it. I'm just going to phone her. I'll think of something different to say.
Hello.
Happy birthday, Miss Jones. You sure got nice bones.
Oh.
Well, that sure was different.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry. Well, Millie, it's your first day as a policewoman. What do you suppose will be the first thing you'll have to learn?
How to blow my whistle.
No, Millie.
That was wrong, right? But I would be willing to wager that later on I will get to learn how to blow my whistle.
Yeah.
That's correct.
Yeah, okay. Right. Now, first thing you're going to have to learn, Millie, is, well, what would you do if, what's the first thing you'd do if you saw two crooks running down the street?
I would call a cop.
Oh, Millie, you are a cop.
Yes, I am a cop. I would call me.
No.
No.
No, no. No, you'd get the crooks to stop.
Uh-huh.
See?
Uh-huh. I see. Well, how?
Well, you'd blow your whistle.
Uh-huh.
See? Like that?
Yes.
And then you'd yell, stop!
Oh!
Like that.
Of course.
Yeah.
How silly of me.
Try it, Millie. Try it.
Okay. Yeah. Just a second.
What?
I do not see one living crook on the street. I cannot do something
no,
without...
No, 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 Millie, you just pretend that you see the crooks. You know, it doesn't matter if there's no crooks. You just pretend you see them, and you blow your whistle, and you get them to stop.
All right,
just,
hold on.
Okay.
Watch this. Stop.
Yeah, well, not quite, Millie.
Oh, almost, though,
no,
huh?
Almost.
Getting there?
Okay. Like this. Stop!
Aha!
See, a little masterfulness.
Got it. Little pig iron.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Here we go. Stop?
Yeah. No.
You don't look certain.
Well, see, you're close, Millie, but not... Look. Stop!
Oh!
See,
now, look.
And,
I am going to get it right this time.
Right.
Would you like to bet that I am going to do it so great this time you will faint?
I believe in you.
All right, here we go.
Okay.
You ready?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Stop!
Oh, great, Millie. You got the makings of a fine policewoman.
I had that feeling.
Yeah.
You see, I have this...
Millie, two crooks. Look, running down the street. No, Millie, get them. Blow your whistle. Get them to stop.
Hey, you guys!
The next word you see will self-destruct in 10 seconds. Can you read it before it does?
Musical mites, the Short Circus, singing their brand new hit, Stop.
I'm giving you my notice, my crying days are through. I'm standing close to happiness, is what I'm gonna do.
Hey, You guys? Hey, you guys!
And now it's time for a very short book. Hansel and Gretel. Hansel and Gretel found a house. The house was made of cookies. Then a witch came and chased them away.
Yeah!
It was her house.
Let them eat their own house!
The end.
Look out. Easy reader, that's my name. Reading, reading, that's my game. Love. Top to bottom, left to right, that reading stuff is outside. Easy reader, that's my name, I say.
Living breed.
What's happening, Al? What's happening, baby? Long time no see. What you got new in my favorite junk store?
Got some good junk from my favorite reading frump.
Hey, Al, man, that's reading freak, my man.
Frump freak, whatever. I got some good stuff for you. Where do you see this?
Show it to me.
Gotcha a necktie with the label on the front.
Will you get to that right there? Thai Town. Genuine. Silk.
It's you.
Don't you know it?
It's you.
What else you got?
I got your beautiful painting.
Oh, come on, Al. You know ain't no worries on no painting.
No, and that this fella that painted this, his name was so long that he had to do the painting down here in the corner.
Yeah.
Then all he right. did his name up here.
Check this out, will you? John, George, Henry, Louis, Raphael III. My man's got a name.
Listen, suppose you're out in the rain or something someday and you don't got nothing to read.
Yeah.
Got you this umbrella with old weather reports pasted inside of it.
Inside?
Take a look. Huh?
Sunny and mild today. High near 70. Look, Al, would you look at that? Precipitation probability near zero.
Yeah. Right? Okay.
Precipitation.
Now look here at my pride and joy.
Yeah.
This is the first graffiti ever back from the 13th century, writ on this night. Fell asleep under a tree and somebody wrote it on him.
Look at this, will you? King Arthur is a fake.
They said that.
Well, that's graffiti, all right. Look at this. Sir Lancelot loves Lady Elaine Fairchild.
It's the real thing. Now, listen, let me wrap this stuff up for you and you can get on your way.
Wait, Al, wait a minute now. Not so fast, man. You got a lot of stuff here. I got to think about this a couple of days, you know.
Oh, you kidding? This stuff is going to go.
Oh, Albert, who's going to want to buy all this junk, man?
Hello. I'm looking for a tie with a label on the front and a painting with a picture in the corner and a suit of armor with graffiti on it.
Right on. I groove on all the words around.
what's my name, I tell you. I'm a reading man, and it's words I see. Every word I see, I just gotta speak. I'm a first-class genuine reading freak. Woo! Easy reader, that's my name, I tell you. Cooling it now.
The Adventures of Letterman. What a dragon. The spellbinder never rests. He comes upon a farmer riding in a wagon.
Come on, get up there, Nellie.
Takes his magic but misguided wand and turns the W into a DR. Needless to say, the farmer is surprised to find himself riding a dragon.
What's going on here?
And especially a dragon of the farmer-eating variety.
Oh, boy, a juicy farmer. My favorite. Wah, wah, wah.
Will the farmer be eaten by the dragon? Oh, where is Letterman?
Help! Help! Help!
Suddenly, out of a tree he comes, faster than a rolling O, stronger than silent E.
Shh.
Able to leap capital T in a single bound. It's a word. It's a plan. It's Letterman. Taking a W from his chest, he covers up the DR and turns the dragon back into a wagon.
What's a big idea?
Well, you can't win them all.
Our villain's day is never done. You can be sure that he will strike again.
Tune in next time when Pedro will take on Maurice with some...
The Electric Company gets its power from the Children's Television Workshop.
Bette Midler sang backup vocals on the Electric Company song, Right On.